This is the YGTV News with Georgina White.
Welcome to the YGTV News. These are the main headlines today on Wednesday, the 1st of February. I'm Georgina White. GSD response to the future job strategy. New employment training scheme begins today. Chief Minister urges Spain to concentrate on unemployment rates. Health and safety audits for schools. Local man sentenced to 8 months imprisonment for intent to supply cannabis. And finally, GSD displeased with government's statement on norovirus in St. Bernard's Hospital. Following yesterday's report on the GSD's response to the future job strategy, Shadow Employment Minister Daniel Feetham spoke to YGTV today to highlight the shortfalls of the scheme.
In a statement yesterday, the GSD noted that any person on the scheme who is not offered employment by the private sector will be sacked by the government company after their training is complete. All the scheme trainees have been told that if that is the case, they will be moved on to another placement until they are offered employment by the private company they're training for. Which is the correct information?
Well, we believe that we are correct. Look, the position, as it was argued during the general election, was you finish your training, you will be guaranteed a full-time job at the end of it. And the implication was that the full-time job would be within a government-owned company. We now know that that is not the case, and that effectively people will not even be allowed onto the scheme. People will not be allowed onto the scheme unless they've already got an offer of a full-time job offer by a private company within the private sector before you go onto the scheme. Or alternatively, it's the government itself that actually invites you onto the scheme because it's able to match your skill with skills available in a private company. Now, it's, as I said before, impossible to guarantee a job in that kind of situation. Now, even if you take the GSLP's position at its highest, they say, well, we'll just simply move you to another placement. What are they saying? Are they saying that effectively people are going to be in a perpetual state of training? It's absolutely ridiculous. What they should be doing is honouring their commitment as they expressed it in their manifesto and also the last general election. People that finish their training courses should be offered full-time jobs because that is what they were. That is what the promise was at the last general election. And now what you see is a situation where they've managed to attract all these votes, and of course they're now backtracking because it's impossible. They've found out that it's impossible to actually employ 1,000 individuals within effectively the public sector in a government-owned company.
To watch the rest of Mr. Feetham's interview, check out YGTV Presents section on yourgibraltartv.com. Today saw the official signing of all trainees to Employment Training Company Limited. A meeting between Minister Joe Bossano and 500 vocational trainees took place this morning at the Insys Hall Theatre. Mr. Bossano noted that if a trainee's provider agrees to a full employment contract after the end of the 11-month training period, they must sign a contract with the employment training company. If the provider fails to honour their commitment, they will be fined the sum of wages that has been given to the trainee throughout the training period. Every month, the trainee and provider must submit a progress report to the company. Every 3 months, trainees will meet with Mr. Bossano for a further review. On signing of the contract, trainees were given general information on the new scheme and their monthly report that includes an appraisal form. Within the contract, it states that trainees are entitled to 18 days per annum of holiday and 2 weeks of sickness pay, the amount allowed to any employee in the first year of full employment. Trainees will receive a wage of £912.60 a month before tax and social insurance. Mr. Bossano also responded to the GSD's discontent over the new scheme.
Mr. Feetham has come out in an article today apparently trying to bury what we're trying to do on the day that it is being born. I hope that he will come around to the view that what we're doing is a good thing and that he will at least give us a chance to try and make it work before he starts finding fault with it. We haven't yet done anything which can be criticized because today is when the new company starts employing people. The purpose of the exercise is to convert the system that existed until yesterday into one that will give you a guaranteed job at the end of the time in the company.
In an interview on Spanish Punto Radio yesterday, Chief Minister Mr. Picardo said, with 5 and a bit million unemployed, I have the impression that the Spaniards have other priorities. The statement came about after a question about sovereignty of Gibraltar. Mr. Picardo also said that in the 21st century, the objective should be to work together, and he extended an invitation to Señor García Margallo to visit Gibraltar to understand the reality of his small nation. He said that nobody understood the Spanish Foreign Minister when he said the joke of Gibraltar was over. The Chief Minister also insisted that Gibraltar had the support of David Cameron. He noted that around 6,000 Spaniards worked in Gibraltar every day, whilst only a dozen Gibraltarians worked in Spain. Ministers with responsibility for education and health and safety, Mr. Gilbert Ligudi and Mr. Paul Balban, have today announced the commencement of a health and safety audit of all the government schools and the college. The first site visit took place on Tuesday, the 24th of January. The audit process will examine the full range of health and safety issues affecting both staff and pupils, as well as looking at general school policies, systems and procedures. On Monday, the 30th of January 2012, Ryan Catini of 18 Macmillan House pleaded guilty at the Magistrates' Court to one charge of possession with intent to supply 122 grams of cannabis resin and to one charge of possession of a controlled drug, namely 122 grams of cannabis resin. Mr. Catini has been sentenced to 8 weeks imprisonment on the charge of intent to supply. And finally, in a press release today, the opposition has declared that the statement given by the government last night in response to concerns over the suspected norovirus outbreak at St. Bernard's Hospital was irresponsible and ill-timed. It has taken questions from the opposition for the government to make any information public about a suspected norovirus outbreak which has already affected 10 patients. In the government's statement on the virus, they noted that it is suspected but not confirmed. The opposition responded to this claim with, if these past 2 weeks the virus had not yet been identified, why was the ward in question, Victoria Ward, not quarantined until the government was sure the public was safe? That's the YGTV News. I'm back tomorrow evening. See you then.